Hello everyone, hi and welcome to the channel Wall Street Mojo. To know more about this video, changes in working capital, watch the video till the end. And if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon that's given below. Welcome everyone, today we have a topic with us is changes in net working capital. Let me give you a short synopsis what is going to be a tutorial this is going to be all about. So, first topic is going to be what are the changes in the net working capital. Post facto, we will try and understand some of the steps, how the flow will run, and then we will work on the analysis part of the changes in the working capital. So once we have got the concept, once we have got the drill down of the steps, we are going to do some analysis work, and post facto it will be in conclusion to the whole topic. Well, let's begin. Now, as you can see over here, there is a chart of the net working capital of Colgate-Palmolive company, and the changes here is that it starts, okay, and there is a drip downfall. Okay, let me just give you a background. See, changes in net working capital is defined as a difference between the working capital from the current year, okay, working capital of the current year and previous year. So the working capital is a firm's current asset. Working capital is equal to firm's current asset minus firm's current liability. Okay. Well, this is going to be the scenario. Now, the formula is over here, something like this. The changes in the net working capital is equal to in net working capital is equal to working capital of current year minus working capital of previous year. Okay, so you can also do this by, you know, just write change in a net working capital formula is equal to change in current asset less changes in current liability. Now, how to calculate the changes in the net working capital? Very important. So first, we will do step one. See, the step one is to find the current asset for the current year. Find out the current asset for current year and previous year. Remember. Okay. So, from the current point of view, we consider inventory is the first thing. Post facto, we take into account the account receivables and so-called prepaid expenses. Now, the step two. Step two is to find the current liability for the current year and previous year. So, from the current liability, we consider accounts payable, interest payable, and deferred revenue. Then comes the step number three, which is you need to find the working capital for, find the working capital for current year. Okay. So that is equal to current assets less current liabilities. Okay. And working capital of the current year, current assets minus current liabilities. Then comes the step number four. Step number four is to calculate the change in the net working capital using the formula. So the formula is working capital of current year less working capital of previous year. As simple as that. Now, see the snapshot over here of Colgate's 2016 and 2015 balance sheet number. The total current asset is standing at 4,338 and 363,305 is the total current liabilities. Total current assets minus total current liabilities. Let's calculate the working capital here. So how will we be calculating? So the current asset of 2016 of Colgate, let me just bifurcate 2016. Current asset was 4338. Current liability was standing at 3305. So working capital will be current assets minus current liabilities, that is 1033 million. Now we'll calculate same for 2015, and we saw the 2015 numbers that were standing at 4384 and 3534. This is everything is in terms of dollars and millions, basically, you can see. So is equal to, well, that's it. Now you will have the net change in working capital. Net change in working capital will be, I'll just merge the entire thing. I'll say previous year, current year, minus previous year net change in working capital. That will give us $183 million. That is the cash outflow, net change in working capital. So, how does the analysis go here? Well, change in the working capital does not mean actual change in the value year over year. It means the change is in the current assets minus the change is in the current liability. So, with the change in the value, we will be able to understand why the working capital is increased or decreased. Let me show you some of the number of actions that will cause in net change in working capital. First reason is that if the company does not allow outstanding credit, the account receivable will get reduced. Okay, but sales may be having a declining effect. Now the inventory planning also impacts the changes in working capital. So an increase in inventory increases the usage of cash. Now third is stretching the accounts payable. It impacts the changes in the net working capital. So if the growth rate of the company is high, then it uses cash more for buying inventories and increasingly the account receivable. So the cash will be heavily be used, right? So basically it is what we call as an indicator of the operating cash flow, and it is recorded on the statement of the cash flow. And the cash flow is one of the important factors to be considered when we value a company, because it indicates whether the short-term assets are increasing or decreasing with respect to the short-term liabilities. Okay, from 1 year to the next year. So the conclusion is that if the net working capital is increasing, we can conclude that the company's liquidity is also increasing. Okay. So it could indicate that the company is able to utilize its existing resources in a better way. Some companies have negative, they have what we call as negative working capital, and some companies have positive working capital, as we have seen in some of the examples. Generally, companies like Walmart, which has to maintain a large number of inventory, they usually have negative working capital. The software companies, they generally tend to have positive working capital because they do not have to maintain an inventory before they can sell the product. So it means it can generate revenue without increasing the current liability. So the cash flow cannot increase or decrease with only change in working capital. But if it is not sufficient, company's efficiency is greatly reduced. So if the current assets and the current liabilities have increased by the same amount, there would be no change in working capital. Second, if the change is positive, then the change in the current liability has the change in the increased more than the current assets. Third, if the change is negative, it means a change in the current assets has increased more than the current liabilities. So, well, that is it. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like, comment on this video and subscribe us to our channel for all the latest updates. Again, thank you everyone for joining the session.